added to the repo, which is really good. And first of all, I would like to talk about the webcast extension. That's an extension because first of all, in February this year, was created by James.com, and it's already at version 1.1, and requires the Semantic MediaWiki 2.1 to be used properly. And what does this extension? It allows for some webcast navigation, and it answers the question, where am I in the wiki? And how does the page relate to other pages? So it is the 5,000 pages, so you can see these connections. So for example, you have the chart to set up. You have three pages with a special property as a parent page, and you connect it to the value of the area. Then you have the page, for example, Valaria, parent page, Germany, and so on. Yeah? So you need on this main space, you need to add these relations via the special property that's on page. And then you can see, as an example, if you go for example to the market page, you will see the webcam as I added it at the beginning. You see this hierarchy that was built up, and you can see RFK tells me I'm on the Bavaria page, and that is a parent page of Erlang speaking Bavaria, and a child page of Germany. Yeah, and you can see this little arrows pointing to the relation. So it's very nice. And for example, on the last page of hierarchy, you can even put in groups for, let's say, relations on the same level. Yeah. We have a little pop-up, and it tells you, there are another two pages connected as a child page to this Bavaria page. Yeah. This is really quite nice. Then you can, let's say, move on to this pop-up and directly access these pages too. And there are different ways to manipulate the display of these webcams. You can see you can have talks, and now you just have the configuration setting. You can have the box, you have the box. You can even have a customized by CSS, so you have special classes for these boxes. And there's even possible to have a type, for example, as a divider, and then you would have this little
and events already created
video, so you can have a look and see it in action. A bit more dynamic than I'm able to do it here now. And it's really a nice thing to do, so you could check it out. So the next extension was the Semantic MediaWiki extension. That's a very interesting one. It was also released in February 2015, so it's from the beginning of the year. Also the text on this one. And currently it's a third one on one device, Semantic MediaWiki 2.12. And what does this extension do? It allows for writing navigation and between pages of a language written relation. Yeah. So if you have page from the same subject in another language, we'll soon see what it exactly means. So and you have two other functions, one other function in the language link. Which is creating links to the pages, related pages in other languages on the sidebar at the bottom. You know this from Wikipedia. On Wikipedia you have these links to other language instances. Here in this extension you can have it within one instance. You still have a range of these links in the sidebar. And the interlanguage listener can part of which allows you to add let's say a language bar onto the page at the point where you put the parser function, and then it indicates you on the page cursor before there are three or four other languages related to this page. So, and you have a lot of special properties to establish the relation on the page as such. Yeah. And you can, since it's important, you can really follow this information at other pages, and that's quite nice. So again, we have an example set up to see these pages or lines. Then you could be the language link that's optional, that's the bar navigation to languages you can have, and the interlanguage link bar function tells you are I am in the sidebar. So we have a page of minds, the same thing in French, Mayans, and Laguncia, that's Galahad. So you see the interlanguage link, it established the relation between the language and the master pages minds in this test. Yeah? So you have to, in every case, add the interlanguage link other function. So, for example, the result is that you have to learn how to page for Mainz in Catalan, Valencia, I want to pronounce it correctly. And you see this navigation bar, that's the language list, other functions, pages, and those automatic buttons in the sidebar are your page in German and French on this page. So, I just imagine a bit, but it's the same page. Yeah? You just have to imagine this a bit bigger screen and then you. Can see this, yeah? And now we have a look at the special mouse page. Yeah? So you see, yeah, at the bottom you have incoming pages from the other language pointing to this page, and you have the interlanguage link, which tells us the mouse page in German. Yeah? And if you look at this interlanguage link, and if you press this little eye there, you can see. Okay, now I could have a version, but the image was there. So it uses the special quality page translation to define how it's the page is in Catalan, and whatever this page, the master page, but it's mine, and you see the language in the morning book. So this is how you establish the connections between these languages. And the nice thing is you can filter by the language, so you can say, okay, actually it's generally an English language instance facility, but you can say, okay, I look for minds or content in general, and can just filter for content in Catalan. So if I have 20 pages in Catalan, 50 in French, 20 in German, 2 in English and so on, I could say, colors show me all the pages which match the color line, and then you can put in searches here. This case I search for mine, and then CR, I get a good CR, and it's shown. Yeah? So there's a page on it, and then you just move on to the page, and it's quite nice. And once again, the quality was next to the one we saw before. It's a GitHub tool, and these are the documentation files, and there's also a video on how to set it up. This you should check out too. This is a very nice one. And the next extension is the Semantic MediaWiki extension. And this one was released in February too, so a lot of things happened, new things emerged in February this year, and we can just propagate this one. And yeah, it allows to add meta elements into the header of the website. So it's a SEO extension, which you most probably will have more on, let's say, closed-ended wikis, but there's a lot of use cases for it. And that's a quite a nice one, yeah, because there are other benefits also. But if you can do it in a semantic way, you can also query for what we've done on several pages. So we have several sites, the classic ones, you know, the keyword description and so on. And it also supports open graph protocol types, and this is all this Facebook stuff. And you have these summary cards, which this is obviously obvious. You have this Twitter, and so we have two possibilities. You can either set these tags fixed by a local settings file, or you can do it manually by deploying annotations. So for example, you know, I want to get the description dynamically, so I just add this to the local settings file, say okay, keywords file, everything I type into the meta element property, keywords element, meta element, keyword property is being shown in the keyword section of this tag, which is added to the header and the description to the meta element description. So there's a lot of others, so on every page you can decide what you'd like to have in these sections of the header. And then here you can see an example page again. You have these keywords, you see it set to a meta element proper keywords property, you have these values, and the same thing for description. So let's move on to the example result, what we have also rendered, and you can see this, we saw ignore robots behind as a bit for the wiki, but it's just a test of so it's going on. And you can see these property values are set into the respective property are now shown as a meta name keywords, the content to the respective one, the same as the description. So this variable according to our setting to every page, you could also add it as a fixed value, for example, the keywords. Yeah? When it's set up for an open graph protocol, for example, that's the thing I would probably do as a fixed property in any case. And to just that's what you add to the local settings file. So you you just set the strings and already provide the value in there. You know, the sandbox, the name, then the picture, that's the picture which is shown, and you, I think you are allowed to post something on Facebook and automatically fetches and see the picture, and you tell Facebook what image type it is and which dimension this picture has, and then it already magically moves in this information, and then you can read or refer to this page and already fetches this information. So you can do the Twitter charts, you know, open graph, there's so many possibilities to describe a header for a page, so there's heaps of possibilities. and then you see the result on this source code of the page. Yeah, we see where the markup sets are now you start with open graph of the markup, and that's what it's kind of if you do a setting. So it's a set fixed setting, and again that's the repository, and the documentation is now, I'd say, a bit more condensed because it's just pretty easy to set up. The other two extensions I already talked about, they need a bit more time to look into it, but with these videos you have there, it shouldn't be a problem. Let's say I manage it, so you will be able to do it too. So the last one, that's really an amazing one, that's not yet released, the semantic site extension, which allows to add citations and references to a page automatically. The first release will be after Semantic MediaWiki 2.3 will be released. Actually, this version is already fixed, so we are talking about days. Or it was already released, I haven't recognized it, but that's nothing to wait long in the future. And as I said, you can manage citation resources via Semantic annotations, and you don't need the site extension. So it's totally dependent. And
so I need to search for citations. Search for citations.
I show you a bit how it's done and then you will see. And actually you use the S site parser function to add nodes or references, and it's comes from a data device. And so you can have it's like this template, which is a parser function, you have to do the data, so you can add information to it, and you can either add these citations manually, or if you fetch this from information database, you can even automatically add this information. And references are mentioned automatically on the page. Or if you would like to do a bit more manually, you can decide on this point, and you can even decide it should it have 1 point, 3 points, and so on. It depends on the situation on the page. And for example, these property annotations, if you have the site information, a lot of info on it, you can decide these are the parameters I type into as a value into property, and you have in the text, if you have done add citations, you can have little tooltips which display important information about the citation, and you can import BibTeX references, and you can create data from databases like Bookmate or Crossmatch and so on via a special page. So that's really a thing which I guess a lot of people will go for, and it's really cool. I'm still amazed. So example, let's print the note that says this site file function, give it a name, say it's a type, it's a miscellaneous information, and the text is this form of text value, and a little element, and it just tells us this note address in these regions of Australia. So that's a simple one, it's just a notepad, and here we have a more complex example. That is actually information text from the Bookmate database. So we have all these parameters, time, titles, outdoor, and so on. And here they have everything. These parameters you can map to a property you would like to it. But we have this Bookmate ID. And that's how you map them. So we have, for example, time, and the property in which the information should be stored is reference part information. So if we go back, you see our type, journal article, and this value, journal article will be added to it as reference, type property, and then you can work with this. Yeah? So this is it. Yeah? And yeah, and it's displayed. Then you can have a template, and it is based on a journal article, and then for reference, that each as reference right, allows you to define a different template, which is controlling how the reference is shown in the reference list on the page. So if you have here we have journal article, perhaps you could have a magazine with other information. Then you could make a different template to it, and you have a different layout, for example, of the citation shown at the bottom of the page, provide an indication on what this reference is all about. And that's a page on 3-day indications, yeah, and that's a quantity graph of it. The citation is such, we already have saved it to Wiki, and we have given it a name. You see on the page before. Here you know the cipher, it has a name, so the site has a function of other, this is my name. And now we add it to a page. And I have a special property subset, the special property which takes the value as a value the name of the citation we have to read it before, and then you have a reference list. This one is because I didn't like the structure on this page, because it was just a reference, it was three columns, and it split up, you know, one reference to three columns, it didn't look nice, so I said, I've different this time, I have only one column, and then I manually add reference to this other function, and then that's how this time. So we only have one column, and that's the reference. If you hover over the little one, you can see this information of interest, which I've signed here on this page, and it's pretty good slides. And that's how you retrieve, for example, this reference I was talking about. We have a special page, which is called Find Site Metadata. You know, we have different possibilities. You can have DORI or OCMC information as well. But these five are supported. You select the type, you have the number. Okay, ID, you put tick fit, a search. And then the parser, the fetch page, fetches information and automatically types it into a copy of the site parser function. Yeah? Then you could manually actually add it to some page on the wiki, or you just press on this right hand side the create button and it adds it to the wiki, and then you have full access to this citation. That's a really good thing. Yeah? So you can do a mapping to the properties, you know, there's the properties that there are about this property and so on and so forth. And then you see the journal. I am a reference template to it, yeah, because this type of population should always have this identical display on the wiki. And that's you need kernel of the server to do it, it's done by a kernel to fetch information. And yes. And the repository is GitHub 2, and we have here, because that's a more complex extension. Actually, I've only shown you the top of it. You can do much more than that. And five videos already there showing you how you can set it up to work with it. And there's also a lot of documentation. And so there are 9 documentation pages, plus these usual ones you would find for an extension. It's in the docs folder on the extension in the repo or in the extension. So you can look at the server and have a look. And that's a cool one too. And of course some other extensions added to the That's it for example for me from now. We are extending to the URL to the GitHub repo, it's more reliable, for example the semantic sign-up extension and so on. That's something for